We are here to worship. in Lord worshiping. He is the Lord above all others. There is no comparison. There is nothing that can stand him. We call him the Alpha and we call him the Omega. He is the Lord of your life. He is the power that fights your battles. Just worship him for who he is. Satan has failed. Satan has lost the battle in your life. He has lost the battle over you. He has lost the battle over your family. Just worship him. If he thinks he can continue to hold you down, he lies. There is a mighty God.
I thank you, Lord, because you can never be too late to receive. Whenever you
battle of your life that you have been fighting. The enemy may have been succeeding, but now the Lord says, tell my children that I want to take up that battle tonight.
Oh, Okay. Yeah. Tell somebody God bless you. Tell my God bless you.
God bless you.
Exodus chapter 24. I want you to go there. Exodus 24 from verse 12. Are you there? And the scripture says, the Lord said to Moses, the first thing for a man to be free from confusion is to listen to God. God will always speak. And I always tell you that God will always speak. As you are here listening to me now, God is speaking to you. And somebody will be receiving God's word for the very situation this passing through. A lot of you have had that kind of experience. That at the end of meeting like this, you say, ah, God, how do you take me away from me? I've been going through. And at the end, you just discovered that everything you were going through, God was addressing them. God still speaks. So you must believe in the God who speaks. If you don't know that God speaks, you will not be able to escape the confusion that the enemy will sow into your life. Spiritual maturity comes through knowing that God still speaks. You can't grow if you think that God is just a God there. You know, sometimes when I read some articles or WhatsApp, especially when people begin to argue with God, and some will say, leave it for God now, let God judge. In other words, the way of escape to accept confusion. So you want to throw it away. You don't blame God. Don't speak for God. If I don't speak for God, who will speak for God? Because they don't know God will speak. So they cannot even hear me, even when I speak. God raises men and they speak to us through men and through his word. But don't also be confused. The devil also speaks to people. So we will get to understand how to escape and discern each of these. But they know God's speaking. You must come to that in your life. God does speak. Once you settle that in your mind, it means that you'll be ready to receive when God begins to speak to you. You will have confidence because one thing the devil, like he did and I did, God say, he wants to confuse you so that you don't believe that God can talk.
Thank you.
confusion came because the men of Israel that Moses told that this is God who has sent me. You know what they said to Moses? They said, sorry, we don't understand what you are talking about. He came to Pharaoh and said, the God I have sent, he said, let my people go. Pharaoh said, you are talking nonsense. You are talking nonsense. You are a joker. Who is God? Why were they saying that? Because they don't know the God that sees. But the Israelite was so discovered that God is the God that sees. When God began to demonstrate his power in the plagues that were coming upon Egypt, then they now put it and said, I'm not sure, not sure. From that moment they knew that when Moses said God said, they will obey and they will hear him. Now, settling that in our mind, the Lord said to Moses, come to the mountain to me. Come to the mountain. The mountain is a representation of God's presence. A child of God was led to go to the mountain. And going to the mountain simply means that you are leaving every distraction to face the Lord. That is how to hear God. And that is how to understand where God is leading. And that is one way to fight the confusion in your mind. Come to the mountain. Away from the crowd. Away from people. You must learn how to spend some time away from people. Just as we do the Lord. And someone say, hallelujah. He said, come on. And while you are here, I will give you two stone tablets which contain all the laws that I have written for the instruction of the people. God gives you something that you need for your life's journey every time you come to the Lord. The Bible says, anyone who comes to the Lord will be not cast away. Isn't it? And he said, come to me with all your heart. You need to know that whenever you come to the Lord, he will give you something. As you are here right now, listening, there is something God is going to deposit in you. And I am saying, while you receive what God has for you, don't pay attention to the confusion the devil will bring up in our words. He said, come, while you are here, I will give you two stone tablets that contain the instruction that you deliver to the people. And you know that the more you get instruction from the Lord, the more you have peace of mind. Every word of God silences the confusion that prevails over your life. Every time you hear the word of God, to hear the word of God is to receive it. That's why a heart that is troubled comes into the presence of the Lord and he hears the Lord, and at the end he goes back home at peace with himself. He goes back home all confident. He goes back home satisfied. He goes back home joyful. Why? Because the word of the Lord has come to set itself on you. Something you need to understand better is that it is not enough. And I'm going to remind you that God remain on the mountain forever. You're not going to remain on the mountain because you will still come down and you will face reality. The training of the mountain is to strengthen you to face the reality of the in the valley. That no matter what, you are looking forward to the hope that is in you, the hope that you have in Christ, and you understand. When Jesus on my side, I am a victor. You need to keep hope alive because you will face again. That muster that cause confusion in your life. Amen. Now, the scripture says, verse 13, Moses and his helper Joshua got ready, and Moses began to go up the holy mountain. He began the journey to go to the holy mountain, he and his helper. Now in verse 14, Moses said to the leaders, wait here in the camp for us until we come back. Wait here until we come back. You see, when you are facing battles in your life, when you know that there are enormous tasks ahead of you, you must learn to get to the mountain. Don't be in a hurry to want to get a solution. Don't be in a hurry to want to finish your assignment. Always know that when you walk with the Lord, time may not necessarily be what gets you to where you are going, but the grace that walks with you. There will be people that will be running and running and running far before you. But when the grace of God gets to you, you discover that you have left them behind. And you are telling yourself, I thought that I have these people left before me. How come I am ahead of them? That is a man who learned not to wait on the Lord. Amen. So there is this confidence that they will come back. But hear what he said to them. He said, whoever has a dispute to settle can go to them. When there is a problem, tell them to handle it. But know that I'm going to gain strength because you will face more challenges. Now, verse 15 says, Moses went up on Sinai and a cloud. The cloud represents the presence of the Lord. It covers. And the scripture says in verse 17, the dazzling light of the Lord's presence came down. Hallelujah. And this is what you need. The dazzling light of speaking light came down. For Moses to discover henceforth that if he's going to get to the promised land and succeed over this people, he needs the light to go with him. Light settles confusion. Wherever there is light, confusion will be settled. So you need to go to God's presence, and when you get into that presence, the light of God comes. This is what the Lord had made known to me, that my light will go with you. And when the light of God accompanies you, there is nothing to be afraid of. And I discovered that every time I get into prayer, there is a light that fills the place. Because why? God affects his presence by light. And wherever there is light, there's going to be peace. Desire to walk and dwell in the light of God. This is the secret. This is the secret of overcoming your confusion. And when you walk in the light of the Lord, what does God expect from you? He means that you should stop focusing on the confusion. Many people get carried away with the confusion. This is the word from the Lord to all of you. If you are going to conquer and be victorious, the Lord said, leave the confusion alone and let your heart follow me. Do you hear that?
Don't try to go your way. Let God lead you.
to conquer our confusion. You must be sincere. You must let yourself walk well, because the enemy will rise. They will rise to attack you and accuse you. The only reason for your peace is that you know that the accusation is useless. When accusation is useless, you don't waste your time fighting a useless accusation. Are you hearing me? Don't waste your time gloating and shedding tears over useless accusations that have no foundation. Then the God you are serving will take up that battle in your life.
Amen.
So you need to learn to trust God, and you need to leave confusion behind and focus on God. Everyone say, focus on God. That can settle your confusion. He says, dwell in glory. Dwell in what? In glory. When you learn to dwell in the glory of God, I'm telling you, confusion will find its way. It will go behind you. Dwell in glory. Let your concern be the glory of God. Let your concern be what God. All others will be behind you. Number three, the Lord says, spread the light. Spread the light. Anywhere you go, let your light shine. You are not living because of somebody. If you live to please human being, you lose your light. If you live to glorify God, your light will keep shining. So wherever you find yourself in life, wherever God positions you, spread the light. And it is this light that will stand to fight every darkness that will come against you. Amen. Then the Lord says, if you do this, I'm quoting the Lord. Quoting what he said to me, what I heard him say, if you do this and forget the world and love God in prayer, he says, you will. Are you hearing me? You will excel and what? And prosper. Hear what the Lord says. Your God is capable to give you what you are looking for out there. God is capable. Your parents say he's capable. That's why I want you to trust him. God is capable. So the Lord will be for us. Leave the confusion alone. Let your heart follow Jesus. As long as God leads you, you will receive the ability to do exploits. Amen.
Amen.
As long as God leads, you will receive the ability to do exploits.
Amen.
This is the promise of the Lord.
Amen.
I wish to pass my message the Lord gave me. I do pass it at the end of the program. I'll still repeat it. But I want to give you God's message for you. All of you, including myself. And the Lord said, tell my children, tell them to focus on me, not the world. Tell them to focus on me, not the world. There is pleasure in me and not the world. Have you ever seen the Lord smile before? Have you ever seen the Lord smile before? Hallelujah. I think there is a young man here that saw the Lord smile. And when he saw the Lord smile, he started smiling himself. This God When you see God smile, you don't have any reason not to smile. When God smiles at you, it simply means that it is settled. You were very happy to see the Lord today, right? Please give me my question. I want to. This young man has gone through so much. The devil is a liar. Everybody says the devil is a liar. I said before, every day for the tea. One day. Where is your sister? Rachel. Is she here to come? With these two people, the Lord is going to do great things for their family. Yes. Something has been happening to them. They've lost their mother, lost two brothers, right? And just lost their father. And two of them remain. The first the first time they lost their mother first, right? And when the mother died, the useless people came. You see, without knowledge, it's difficult to understand what to do. But don't worry, God will always have a way of believing her power away. What was your dream when your mother died? Tell us.
And you ask them,
they said they are not finished. You know what they said? They told him they are not finished. When God rises, the enemy must go down.
This was a Peter from
He says to put down it. And Father Vincent, they are both brothers of the same spirit.
When there is confusion, what can happen to a man? So he was confused and he went and laughed with the doctors. He was doing well at the war. All of us were born in one family, we were so small, we didn't know what was happening. People were going from different places to eat, goat, ram, chicken, all of those things. But you see, because God has blessed his family to be a family that will be blessed later, my elder brother was sent to a Catholic school. Then it was run by the missionaries. And of course, you know, they were brothers and he was going to church. That was my brother got converted and became a Christian. So anytime he came home, he was going to church. He became a war between him and my father. The father was like, I want to destroy the home. So after him, my elder brother started going with him. And me and my brother are very Christians. So eventually, all of us became Christians. And that home, and you could have seen, it was a battle between us and my father. It was not easy for us to become Christians, actually, plenty of us, Mark, all of us, on Sunday, my brother would drop the keg of water and go to farm. And he would tell me, bring this keg with water to bring the farm on Sunday. We will not bring him to go to church. Then he will go to farm. So he will work from Monday to the hour without food, without water, because of God. He will not come back in that area. You can imagine what will happen. You can imagine what will happen. At least, I will tell you one day, when he got my brother Mr. he was beating him, he was kicking him, he was biting him at the same time. Because we often become Christians. At the time, he told us, the school uniform is good for us. He told the tailor to take it. That we should not believe that, and that should sponsor us in this case. And then I had the responsibility, and he saw us also for this reason. But you see, this woman that my elder brother married, before he married the woman, everybody was telling him, leave this woman alone. The father was a notorious user. If the man tells you to die, he will ruin your life. And if you beat his head and tell me, you know who I am, ask me who I am. If I tell you the dad, I will die. That was how it was. And my other brother, when he got the one pregnant, the man came and told my brother, are you the one that I tell my daughter? Yes, you must marry her or I will kill you. And so, my brother was afraid and he married a woman. The woman was on mission, but we didn't know. She not came and sat down. All of us were living with my brother. So the woman with the good food and me and all of us were eating. We were all eating, we were all going together, we were all going together. But we didn't know what God was doing. So as we were growing up, becoming what God wants us to be, we now start experiencing what we call difficulty, serious challenge. You can go to the place, you get there, anybody will be welcome. And you will be welcome. After a short while, they will single you out and tell you to go somewhere else. You can go to a place, everybody will like you. 3 nights. Unknown places we need to attack you every night. It was a war. So we didn't know. But I want to tell you, when I was a young education sport, he said we knew. Then he was back at school. 27th of December, 1999. My mother died. And because my father died while I was in this family, that should be some 29 years ago. My mother believed that everybody was okay. And so, he made the amount of action sometimes. In the morning, she was because she don't know where or where she was. Just tie her back without saying pass. She would just go to the community. And so, somebody was out of her. This death, what is your problem? They will show you spiritual level. My mother didn't know that. she was the one who was making progress.
And so all of us were so happy with her.
We didn't know.
So the woman went to that thing and she all the children,
she gave birth and become somebody. None of us was not somebody. And to that woman, they say, he was
anywhere,
and he remembers
remember the what he gave me to his car on the day of the
of course, the car he gave me to the that was the car in the set event. The car was manipulated in such a way that even man, that car, when he sold it, he couldn't buy it. They had to buy the car to the car, they charged the car. So you were not taking the past and bring that car, because nobody could use that car. Now, this is something, a journey of faith, is a life of faith. So it continued that after all said and done, this man was killing everybody one after the other and was fighting them, making sure that nobody was embarrassed. But when we go back to pray for now about that, me, the day was day, I was away from my dad's rumors. Somebody from the crowd said, so this boy did it. So for all those efforts you made, this boy made it. I'm not going to tell you, don't manipulate anybody. My parents was manipulated. And I was not to ensure that I was not ordained. And you see, my God was in this long God. He got an idea and he gave me power from that. Yes, I said, hallelujah! My father gave the way to the people and told them, anything you know that you take this boy, do it so that I can take it to the bishop. While I was on the bishop, he can't take it to the office. He must make sure he looks for something to implicate me while the bishop's office. That is my parish priest. The reason I want him, he gave me the office when I was counting money, I was in transit. He just said, my brother, help me deliver this thing. Meanwhile, the priest came and told me, please, brother, help me to write my name, my receipt. Let me go to the sister's name and correct my heart. I was there. I left what that is came to do and assigned to do. I'm not carrying my bag in my body, my bag is. The moment I finished that is the same as there. Are you pleased what I said to do? My bag is said, do you mind me? I don't make a lot of friends that are doing this. You give me what you left for and tell me something else. Meanwhile, it was you see that you're technical because my bag is. So he never is back and forth and that piece was ready now. When he finished the event, he said, is this really happening? After that, he came the following day and he told me to please help him do something. I told him, brother, sorry. Sister sent the message, his sister was working on that. He said, you have some balance of what I told you to do. He said, what do you mean? You are coming to me, you have to be in a man, how crazy. He was insulting me. At the time, as a man, my eyes got wet. I stood up. The head of my head stood up. And when he saw that a man has stood up like a man to man, he said, I'm sorry for you for this person. I sat back and he now went to the office, reported to the bishop secretary and also to the chancellor. They said to me, why were you insulting your bad priest? I told them, that I did not insult you. I don't need to open my mouth to say the word. But he said, so what happened? I told him what I was saying. Think about him. He is over reaction. That was how that died. But he continued. When my mother died, he insulted my brother who was blind. He told him, that's the brother there, don't remember you are in business. And he left. My brother was home, was doing everything. Somebody who was crying and then he lost his money. See, today, he did not tell me something that my mother died. See, today, I'm calling him doctor. I came. When I came from church for the mass, this mass was already on my brother's daughter. I made that was, I was there doing reading. I think we didn't read this. I made that was going on from the past me. The second time they passed me. Third time they passed me. I have to talk to God. home, I will find my way home. Why were you doing this? Because when my brother begged, then my brother was doing it. So he was crying that I should come to the White House and stay with him in the White House. So that he can now execute all those plans that they told him to execute. But I told him, sorry, father, I will come here for my Sunday, but I will not be in the White House. That was no good of condition. Do you know that after my double relationship, the first thing I gave him, the wife, people like that. Everybody who talked to us and feel up on the money. And they're like, is this a material that this man wanted us to throw away?
Now, when I came
Lion himself has said, who now refer me to God? Say, go to me, my son. Team up with that you and conquer this battle in front of me. So I came back, I'm the last of my family, but I think I had a relationship with my where I was recreating my family. He said, yeah, God has told you to do that. So he said, people should know this prayer, do this prayer, do prayer, and we're happy with prayer. When we finish, I'm calling him, we're going to ask full people of business. So one day, I was going to have my call, or maybe your call. He said, what are you going to do? He said, okay, you follow your prayer, let us see how we are going. I was walking in the rain. I saw this woman. She just, a cloud of darkness appeared. People just appeared in my phone. And she was much blacker. All of a sudden, she started crying. You see what I mean to me? You see what I mean to me? Look at my body. I said, Father, I'm not going anything to you. You are not my will. Are you there? She fled. But all of a sudden, a white snake, totally white, fell down from the sky and wanted to bite me. And I'm gone. So I thought, Father, that was the point of combat. So that day, the Lord called and said, Father, let us pray. We prayed for 4 hours. On four. 4 hours. From 9 o'clock to 1 in the night. We prayed to pray for our own life. 3 days later, 4 days later, and the slave did the same thing. The slave said, I cannot talk about following your children. And I went. The spirit of the way. I got there. I saw. In 3, under that tree, there were 3 persons sitting down there. 4 posts were there, another post was lying up in the bush. And what I said, can you see the boy? I said, yes. He said, there is one of them that has is covered with this animal skin, but tied with a red cloth. Pick that pot up. I picked it up. And I was asking them, why are people in this us? They said, because when my father was alive, my father protected us. So the moment he died, they now tell my father that they are smarter than my father. That's why they are protecting us. Because if they wanted to help us, my father would tell them, I am here, and you know what I've done, but I'm not going to do it. Oh, is that why I'm going to help them there? Okay, this was what you want to teach. You must say, this is a form of torment and torture. And I said, who the government said, I said, okay, any other thing? He said, it's also a point of confusion. I said, if you have this post here, like, what do you mean? That is the road they will go when they are coming to that land. I said, okay, no problem. But I said, smash the pot of the ground. I smashed it. Toes, that horse, came out of my box. And he called out snake. And some other people asked a question. And I asked them, how many of them this morning? They said, they are paying. The woman there said, they were black as a fool, and told her and I said, tell her this, he called my brother, but that thing he was in change. And I asked him, why are you here? He said he was from Leon. That he was literally told that particular court, but he was not a guest because it was a wife who was looking for him, who he was living with, and so he could not overcome, he could not escape the woman. I said, so you now betrayed your siblings because of this woman who was looking for me. But now that we raise for that horse, destroy the ring, and in the hole made by that guy, that was all this. There was a man, instead of that, was money, bundles of money. And I was at the answer, what is this? They said, that is the words of the coming one. Okay, there was something like that, and as a rod, they used it, they saw it, not the soil is going off. And I was asking, what do you want with this? He said, when they are going to fight somebody and the person is being tough, just like you use the digger to dig the soil that is so strong, that is how they use the iron to dig the face of that person and make sure that they agree with that person down before they strike us. And I'm asking the man, okay, what can we do with all of this person? He said, this is the backport. Anytime they want to attack somebody, they bait in it and disappear into the person's room. When they feel their back, they disappear again and appear inside that house. I broke all of them. So what I'm like, one goes to the other, destroyed everything that they have done. But you know what? At the time, the woman was like, I don't want to go again. Because the woman had passed away, literally initiated some persons into this pot, some children into the pot. There was a lot of people that were able to put, and one of them was full of God. And he initiated children, the man in that pool of God. And the woman told him, all the people again, this is where they did their work. A big tree in front of the church. That was the home. And that place where all that's in meeting. And she told me, this is where the whole meeting on how to unlock the engine of the car that you use. Yes. We also went from that place. When we got there, nobody was there. Inside the bush. And in that place, there was a good many pumpkins. And a very big pump for them. That was their kitchen. And that was where they came. Who was there? One of my nieces. She was a cook in that kitchen. Yes. And the entire other place, it was a graveyard. So many persons were inside caskets. And in that casket, there were three people. I asked them, what did you hear? They said, anybody they want to kill me, they will talk about tell the spirit of that person. Put it in the casket. So when they are striking the person, the person can no longer do anything, can no longer pray until the person finds out. And who was in charge? One notorious little doctor from my village. He was in charge of that place. We also have a particular place where elderly men, myself from them, were seated around the tree. And the woman would go to the tree and begin to root. Those people would be there, elderly men. So she was going, she was there, those people behind her to put her hand out. And she told me that she is so strong that she has to have a hand out of the woman. And in that she came, I am not going to defeat her. So she cannot see me one-on-one to look at my face. Every time I go to my village, I'm not a Christian. She doesn't dare to look at my face. And if I come down, people are visiting me, she will just run immediately and go. She doesn't want to talk to her. I contact. This is the woman very well. So we went to all of those different places, destroying those things, cutting down the trees, burning everything, and all said and done. And God appeared and said, keep up the faith. There is nothing I cannot do. If I have not done it, at least I have not done it to do it. But when I agree to do it, I will do it, and that will be the end of the world. That this woman is a church order in the church. Then I have to let you go. I'm saying this so I would like to know that it is not everyone who comes to church is a child of God. Of course, the matter that you want to say, or that matter that you want, Jesus says, not all those who come to God are inclined to like the one of God. But those who do the will of the Father who is in heaven. There are so many persons in the church. They belong to different folks. Some persons are not Jesus, and you don't know who they are. Yes. In the past two I want, I had people confronting me that you, anything the partners are afraid to do, you will come out and tell me, who are you? So don't let me know. I thought that's why I come to the church communion, that person is only Christian. You have to confess that it's doing it to us. The young woman, even in the church of my wife's house, in front of the other, they're not very important chance. And you know what she said? She said, I asked her what you said. She said, this pot, I use this pot to confuse everybody in the church so that they can hurt you and your siblings and believe that you people are bad in front of the other. And so, any thing that comes to me, what the kind of thing about us will be doing is, you see them doing them. That have been praying with them for ages. That is it. And then when we went to the last one, there was in the old bedroom, many people were supposed to go to the village. said, you see this, in those days, when I want to find somebody, those who exist come, I will pour the water from this place on them, and they will come back in the spirit. Now, what do I do? Sometimes, when you are paying every day, you are paying all the money out of money, all of a sudden, you cannot pay again. Sometimes you are supposed to go. Tell them you have to do your best. Seek the face of God. Do not just say, I've been so late, I don't pray again. The devil is pulling you out from the presence of God. Then they have a lot of things they use. A lot of things they use. So today, when I don't tell you, I am with you. Since then, I am with you. I don't fear anybody. Of course, you know that they complain that. I had been so difficult for her to hold. I had been so difficult for her to hold. She had tried everything. Let anybody say, go. She will go and be so difficult. Let me repeat that for that. I will write a deed. Yes. In one of my meetings, a lady came. A man before that meeting, I had a revelation. When that woman denied that she was right, and what will they do? We were discussing on how to kill me. Don't stop me, baby. I just told her to be one. So you think that you can kill me. When I was preaching and all that, I started talking about this thing. The woman stood up and walked away. She stood up from the all night and walked away from the church. Before any day she came, she said, I want to support the all night. He brought her over there. She has charged the money. I told her, man, I don't want to pay. I need the money. Let me pay for you. She said, no. I was trying to listen, but this man decided by all the rights he would not go until I pay the money. And he said, don't allow her to touch this money on your body. He said, this is your hand. The moment I took the money, if you see the electric shock that went from my hand, my body. So let me see. I said to my house, I didn't make a fight. I went to the house. I prayed for that one to leave me. That one I did not remember. She became sick. And that woman called me to come and pay me. And today, I am telling you that God, this Almighty God, the Holy Spirit God, the Holy Spirit God of worship, will make your enemies to lead them before God.
Started manifesting.
we must fight to win, to deserve the crown.
I'm going to have our priests. They are going to stretch their hand, they will not speak. Because whatever the power sitting on your testimony,
somebody will say,
my life, I feel happy. They don't feel happy, they happy.
Whatever the power fighting your glory, whether they be from your household or your neighborhood, and every call they have come to, imagine. 21 codes just to fight destiny. I want all of you to please go on your knees. You are not an orphan. You are not an orphan. That's people. Toiling with their destiny.
Enough is enough.
And the Lord told Father and his family, the battle is over. Every white serpent in your home. I told you before, white serpents are familiar presence. People you know, but they are evil. People very close to you appear to be what they are not. There's nobody the devil cannot manipulate. Whether you wear white or you wear green, there's nobody. Whether you are ordained or you are not ordained, there is nobody. The power of God will break every yoke.
You are the king that rules the world.
begin to shatter the power that troubles you. wherever they stand to fight you, let the ground open to swallow them. The owner of your soul, take up your battle. The owner of your soul, take up your battle. They have done enough. Father, we stand as your priest and your servant. For your people, let them be set free from the power that held them down. Every chain they used to hold your life, let that chain be broken right now. Anywhere they take your mantle, let fire consume them. I set you free from their power. I set your generation free from their power. Whatever they have come to tie you down, today that cord is broken. Whatever they have used to tie down your children, this moment that cord.
House. Every wise snake in your family.
Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Lord.
It is well with you.
Yeah.
Every boast they have made will become like a broken pot.
Yeah.
A pot that is broken cannot hold water. And from this moment, anything to hold and put inside that they are burying you, it will become like water in the basket. No power will bring you back to where God has taken you. Anybody they will employ to fight you. Anybody they will hire to fight you. If they can be hired, they can be fired. I command the fire of God to go after those they have hired. You are free. Hear me, if the law has said it, it is done. And I say to you, you all know better. the sign of the cross on your doorposts and make a decree that henceforth no evil, no darkness will have upper hand over my family. Do you understand? You can say it the way you want. You can speak it the way you feel like. But the point is, make a sign of the cross on your doorpost. And as you enter into your house, when you pass through the door, say, from this day that my feet step into my house, from the house of grace, every good thing meant for my home shall come to dwell in my home. Two things: the sign of the cross on your doorpost to cancel every evil and their powers over your house, and when you enter, that the good thing God has written, announced, declared for you shall come to stay in your house. May your testimony be great. May your testimony shake the world. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and you shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Let's stretch your hands. Let this blessing meet your family, your children, those who are far away, your business, your house, your job, your vehicles, everything that concerns you. You see why you can pray over everything? Because the enemy can use anything. So we are releasing blessings on everything that concerns you. So in faith we declare, we'll be right back.